Hello everyone, welcome to the next lesson in your Amazon seller course. In this lesson, I am going to share how to update listings on bulk. So in order to update listings on bulk, we need to use a file called flat file template. So I will be sharing you how to use this flat file template and delete existing listings or change existing listings. In the previous videos, we saw how to do it in single, and in this we will be seeing how to do it in bulk. So before that, I will show you how to download a flat file sheet. Log into Seller Central and click on search and type inventory templates. So here, make sure that you have excluded the forum answers, and you will have an option called inventory file template. Please click on it. So here you will get category wise templates. So this column is called flat file templates. This is a category wise template, and this is a style guide where you will have sample files and also how can you do it and all. And for few categories, they have even video for reference. And another column is that BTG, that is Browse Tree Guide. This will be helpful for mapping the subcategories, and this I'll cover in the upcoming videos where we'll be saying how to create new listings. And this is approval required. For example, for automotive category, you don't need any approval to sell the products. So whereas in clothing category, you need approval to sell the products. And if I scroll down, for pet supplies, you need approval. For personal care, you need approval, but for the other categories, you don't need any approval. So when you are planning to delete or update listings in bulk, there is no need to use category specific files. The reason why I'm saying is that consider that you have 1000 listings, out of which 100 is of baby care and 100 is of, you know, kitchen, and 200 is of electronics. There is no need to download category specific files. Instead, you can use a common file. So first, let me show you how to delete a product. So let me click on inventory, manage inventory. So in the previous video, we created this listings. Now consider that I want to delete this listing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to download a flat file. So this product is of clothing, but I'm going to download. Okay, let me download a beauty flat file. So I'm going to delete this particular SKU in bulk. I am sharing you example for only one SKU, but even if you want to do 1000 listings or more also, you can do using this method. So for this, I'll explain you the basics of this sheet. The first sheet is the data definition sheet. As soon as you download a template, click on enable editing, enable content, whatever the pop-up that you are getting, so that we can work on the file. The first sheet is called data definition. So it will show you what are the valid values you can add for a particular field. For example, let me search for date. I'll search for sale. Yeah, sale start date, sale end date. Here they have mentioned that the data should be in the format of YY, 4YMMD. That means 2019, the corresponding month and the date. So all the data definitions will be in this sheet, and you will have this template sheet where you have to fill the template sheet, and in the valid values, you will have the corresponding value that you have to enter. I'm not going to explain this in this particular video. I'll be explaining this in the next video. So here I'll be sharing you how to delete a product. So for this, you have to enter two columns. The first column is the SKU. So I'm just copying this SKU and I'm pasting the SKU here. There is one column called update partial update delete column. This column is called update delete, and if you select, you will get this drop down. In most of the sheets, this drop down is not working. Now we have to take the help of valid values column. So if you come here, there will be here you will be having the valid values, that is update, partial update, delete. Let me explain all the three. Update, it is used for listings that you are going to create new. So consider that you are going to add a product for the first time on Amazon, you will be using update. Partial update, the product is already on Amazon and you want to just modify one or two of its attributes or many of the attributes, then you will be using partial update. Partial update is suitable only if the product is in your inventory. Inventory, my inventory, or manage inventory. Next is delete. If you want to delete the products, you have to use this. I'm just copying this delete. I'm going to the template and I'm just pasting here delete. So here I have entered the SKU and I'm saying Amazon that see this SKU, please do the function of delete. I'm just saving this file and I'm closing the sheet. So as soon as it's done, come on to inventory, add products via upload. And the step one here is to check the file. Mostly I don't check the file for delete or partial update since those are small tasks. But for adding a new listings, we will definitely do this step. So since it's a small task, what I'm going to do, I'm going to come and choose the file. So this black fail beauty is there. And I'm going to say that please mail me at this particular mail ID once this is done. And make sure that you select this as Excel. Excel is always recommended because you can understand it very easily. And also there's one more thing, that it is not preferred to upload in XLSM, that is in Excel format. It is preferred to upload in tab delimited format. But since this is only a delete function, I have just uploaded this. So even this I will be covering in the upcoming sessions. So once this is done, just click on upload. So within 1 or 2 minutes, you will get a mail, and also you can see the status here saying what is the update, whether the product is deleted or not. So this is the page. Okay, I have only one row. If I just refresh the page, I get it, the time and the batch ID and the upload status is in progress. So if I just wait for 1 minute or something like that, your status should change as upload status done and total number of records submitted or whatever it is. Okay, between then I'll just show you how to update listings. So let me explain what you mean by update. See, consider that I have this product, famous plastic vegetable grater and stator, okay. So consider, I'm just clicking on edit to understand what are the SKUs it has. I mean, what are the features it has. Okay. So I'm just going on description. Description is empty here. And keywords is also empty. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open the same file. So consider that for this SKU, I want to update description and keywords. So I'm going to do that in bulk. So whenever you are updating products, doing partial update, there are 3 columns to be filled. One is SKU, one is partial update column, the next is the attribute to be changed. So first let me fill the SKU. Okay, I got an error right now saying that the cell or chart you are trying to change is a protected sheet. To make sure, unprotected sheet. So if you are getting any error like this working on the sheet, just go on to review tab and click on unprotected sheet. Once you have done it, you can edit this particular cell. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this SKU, I'm going to paste it here. So I said you 3 columns is important. So one is this one and another is partial update. We are going to update the existing listing, so it means partial update. So I'm going to validate values copying this partial update, because if I use some other spelling on with space, it won't work. So I'm just mentioning this as partial update. And the third column that is important is the attribute you want to change. So here I want to change description and also keyword. So it means 4 columns I have to fill. So let me go to description. Description. Yeah, here it is there. So let me enter some text, like, you know, this is a test description. So let's see whether the description is changed or not. And also I want to change the keywords. So keywords. So don't worry, this will be covered in a separate video about the keywords. So just I'm adding some dummy value here. Hi keywords. So once this is done, I have to save the file. So between, let me also change some other product also so that I can show you very easily how things work. But for changing these things, I should be the owner of the product. So I'm not sure which listings was created by me. Let me give a try. Let me give a try by changing the price of this particular listing. So this listing is there. Okay. And this listing, I'm just clicking on edit. And here I have mentioned my price is 187. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to standard price. This your price column will be mentioned as standard price in the Excel sheet. The price is 187. I'm just mentioning this as 150. Okay, and the maximum retail price is empty. It should not be empty as per the new policies. So I'm also filling this maximum retail price as 200. I'm not sure of maximum retail price, but just filling a dummy data. So what I have done, I have filled the SKU, I have filled the standard price, maximum retail price. And then I'm going and mentioning this as partial update. That means I already have this product. Please change this product. So I'm just saving it. And I'm closing the file. So let me come back here again. and click on add products via upload. So this is done. So that means total number of records submitted is 1. So our delete is completed. Let's check it out. But before that, let me update this partial update file. So I'm just saying, please mail to this ID. And this is a flat file. Please upload it. So the upload is in progress. It is in progress. So now let me click on inventory, manage inventory. And if you could see that particular product, you know, that particular bed sheet has been deleted. I don't have the bed sheet itself. So it means that the product is deleted. So even if we want, I can search it as bed sheet. And that bed sheet is deleted. One more thing is that you can even check out your processing report. So if I just click on download your processing report, an Excel sheet will be downloaded. But during upload, if you have selected as text, only a text will be downloaded, so which will be very difficult to track it. So I prefer Excel. So now let's open the sheet and let's see what is the status. Field processing summary, number of processed records is 1. And I'm going to the template. So I use this particular SKU to delete it. So I already mentioned that this SKU is deleted. I'm going to again validate it by using SKU. So I'm coming here, doing Control V and search. If you could see, there is no listings because the listing is deleted. So for delete listing, you will be doing this method. And now let's see what happened to the partial update sheet that we uploaded. So inventory, add products via upload, monitor upload status. So once this is done, they have mentioned that upload status is done. Total number of records submitted is 2. So now what I'm going to do, so these two are the products that I edited. Okay, I think I'm not the product owner, but let me see whether the description has changed. I'm just clicking on refresh. So description, the description has changed. This is the test description and keywords is high keywords. So before there was a blank description and keywords is blank. It was not changing. Now it got changed. And now in this product, if you remember, this price is 187. And I changed that into 150. And MRP is also blank. I added one MRP value also. I'm just refreshing this page. And see, now you can see that the price is changed into 150 and MRP is changed into 200. So in the same way, you can upload or update any attribute. For example, product tax code is one attribute. Handling time is one attribute. So like this, you can update anything using a flat file. It is mandatory to fill SKU, mention partial update column as partial update. And third attribute, whatever you want to change, you have to mention that value. Here, handling time refers to the time that you will be able to ship the product. For example, consider that today I got an order. Your usual handling time is 1 to 2 days. If you need 5 days extra, means you have to mention the handling time here as 5 days. So it is not possible for you to do it one by one. That's the reason we are doing it on bulk. And the reason that why I do always in bulk is that there is two reasons. One is that I will have a backup sheet. So at any time, if I want to just check what did I make the changes, there is one backup sheet for you. And the second change is that, consider that during upload, you got an error. So I will be showing you how you will get the error, how to solve it and creating a new listings, because in that place only you will get a lot of errors. So consider that I got an error and I am not able to solve it. You can raise a ticket to seller support saying that this is the batch ID and this is the error I am facing and these guys will help us out. So if you are doing that in single, you won't have any batch ID and these guys will not help you. Instead, they will say download a flat file and please do it. So for this reason only, I always prefer a bulk sheet. I hope this video was clear. If it is not clear, please check from the beginning, because in the next video it will be very interesting. We are going to create a new listing using flat file, and also I will be teaching how to do parent-child variations, etc. Meet you in the next video.